Could the most iconic ancient structures in the world be hiding an entire city right beneath our feet? In March 2025, the archaeological world was rocked by an announcement that seemed straight out of an adventure film. A team of Italian and Scottish researchers claimed to have discovered something extraordinary beneath the ancient Giza pyramid complex in Egypt. Not just a chamber or a passageway, but what they described as a vast underground city. The potential discovery represents one of the most significant claims about the Giza plateau in decades. According to the research team led by Dr. Maria Conti from the University of Bologna and Dr. Alasdair Fraser from the University of Edinburgh, advanced imaging techniques revealed a complex network of underground structures extending approximately 6,500 feet beneath the famous pyramids. To put that in perspective, that's more than 20 football fields laid end to end, all hidden beneath one of the most studied archaeological sites on Earth. The announcement came during an international archaeological conference in Cairo, where the researchers presented their preliminary findings to a stunned audience. Using a combination of satellite-based synthetic aperture radar, SAR technology, and seismic vibration analysis, the team created what they described as high-resolution three-dimensional images of these underground structures. The images they shared with the public showed what appeared to be an intricate network of chambers, corridors, and open spaces arranged in a surprisingly organized pattern. Perhaps the most intriguing aspect of the claimed discovery is the presence of 8 vertical cylindrical shafts, each approximately 12 feet in diameter. These shafts reportedly connected multiple levels of underground structures, suggesting a sophisticated engineering approach. Dr. Conti described the arrangement as reminiscent of a modern multi-story building, but constructed over 4,000 years ago. The team theorizes that these shafts may have served multiple purposes, from ventilation and movement between levels to potential astronomical alignment functions. The scale of the alleged underground complex is truly remarkable. If verified, it would change our fundamental understanding of ancient Egyptian capabilities and potentially the purpose of the Giza complex itself. Dr. Fraser suggested during the presentation that what we're seeing could represent an administrative center, a ceremonial complex, or even living quarters for those involved in pyramid construction and maintenance. Such a discovery would challenge the conventional view that the Giza plateau was primarily a necropolis and ceremonial center. News of the discovery spread rapidly through both academic circles and popular media, with headlines proclaiming "Ancient Egyptian underground metropolis found" and "Secret city beneath the pyramids." Social media exploded with theories ranging from thoughtful archaeological discussions to predictable claims about alien involvement. The story captured the public imagination in a way that few archaeological announcements ever do. However, the archaeological community's response has been significantly more measured. Within days of the announcement, questions began to emerge about the research methodology, the capabilities of the technology used, and the interpretation of the data. Dr. Zahi Hawass, former Minister of Antiquities in Egypt and one of the world's foremost Egyptologists, expressed strong skepticism, noting that extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence, and calling for a thorough peer review of the data before drawing any conclusions. Other experts questioned whether SAR technology, even when combined with seismic analysis, could actually penetrate to the depths claimed by the research team. Dr. Sarah Parkak, a renowned space archaeologist, pointed out that while remote sensing technology has made remarkable advances, there are still significant limitations to what we can detect at such depths, especially through limestone bedrock. The Egyptian Antiquities Authority has taken a cautious stance, neither dismissing the claims outright nor offering endorsement. They've announced the formation of an independent scientific committee to evaluate the research and determine whether further investigation is warranted. No excavation permits have been issued based on these findings, though the research team has formally applied for permission to conduct targeted explorations. This measured response reflects the complex nature of archaeological discovery in the modern era. The Giza pyramids have been the subject of countless theories and claims throughout history, many of which have proven to be unfounded. Yet, the site continues to yield genuine new insights through methodical scientific investigation. As we await further verification and peer review of this potentially groundbreaking discovery, the questions multiply. If there truly is an underground complex of this scale beneath Giza, how did it remain undetected for so long? What purpose did it serve in ancient Egyptian society? And perhaps most intriguingly, what might be found inside if excavation ever takes place? The coming months may provide some answers as the scientific community works to separate fact from speculation in what could be one of the most significant archaeological discoveries of our time. The technology behind this potential discovery represents a fascinating evolution in archaeological research methods. Traditional archaeology often relied on physical excavation, literally digging into the earth to uncover buried structures and artifacts. But what happens when the areas you want to study lie deep beneath massive ancient monuments? This is where remote sensing technologies come into play, allowing researchers to see beneath the surface without disturbing the structures above. Synthetic aperture radar, SAR technology, the primary method used by the Italian-Scottish team, works on a principle that might seem like science fiction. Unlike optical imaging that captures visible light, SAR systems emit radio waves that penetrate the Earth's surface and bounce back when they encounter different materials. By analyzing these returning signals, researchers can create detailed images of subsurface features. What makes the Giza research particularly innovative is the specific application of satellite-based SAR. The research team employed data from the European Space Agency's Sentinel-1 satellite constellation, which carries advanced SAR instruments capable of collecting data regardless of weather conditions or time of day. This satellite data was then enhanced through a process called interferometric SAR, INSAR, which combines multiple radar images taken over time to detect even subtle changes or persistent features beneath the surface. However, SAR technology alone has limitations, particularly regarding depth penetration. This is where the research team introduced their methodological innovation, combining the SAR data with passive seismic analysis. By placing highly sensitive seismometers around the Giza plateau, the team collected data on naturally occurring vibrations in the Earth. These vibrations, caused by factors ranging from ocean waves to human activity, travel through different underground structures at varying speeds. Dr. Maria Conti explained their approach. "We essentially created a fusion algorithm that combined the spatial resolution advantages of SAR with the depth capabilities of seismic analysis. This allows us to construct a three-dimensional model that revealed structures far deeper than either technology could detect on its own." This methodological approach represents a significant departure from previous technological investigations at Giza. In the 1960s and 70s, researchers used simple resistivity measurements that could only detect shallow subsurface anomalies. The 1990s saw the introduction of ground-penetrating radar, which improved depth capabilities but still couldn't penetrate more than a few meters in most conditions. More recently, muon radiography, which uses cosmic particles to create images similar to X-rays, has been employed to search for hidden chambers within the pyramids themselves. Now, what technology do you think archaeologists should develop next to explore ancient sites without damaging them? Well, let me know what you think in the comments below. The team behind this potential discovery brings together expertise from multiple disciplines. Dr. Alasdair Fraser's background in geophysics provides the theoretical framework for the seismic analysis, while Dr. Conti's specialization in archaeological remote sensing guided the SAR data interpretation. They assembled a team including data scientists, Egyptologists, and structural engineers to ensure a comprehensive analysis of the collected information. The methodology involved multiple phases over a three-year period. First, they analyzed existing geophysical surveys of the Giza Plateau to identify areas of interest. Next came the collection of new SAR data, specifically calibrated to detect subsurface density variations. The seismic monitoring network was then established, collecting data for 14 months to account for seasonal variations. Finally, the combined dataset was processed through custom machine learning algorithms designed to identify coherent structural patterns. This methodological rigor addressed one of the primary challenges in studying deep underground structures, distinguishing between natural geological features and human-made constructions. Limestone bedrock, which underlies the Giza Plateau, naturally contains cavities and fissures that can appear as artificial structures in remote sensing data. The research team claims their fusion approach provides enough resolution to differentiate between these natural formations and the geometric regularity of constructed spaces. Another significant challenge involves accounting for the water table beneath Giza. Groundwater can significantly affect both radar penetration and seismic wave propagation. The research team addressed this by incorporating hydrological models of the area into their analysis, adjusting for seasonal fluctuations in groundwater levels. This technological approach used at Giza represents just one example of how modern tools are transforming archaeological research globally. Similar techniques have revealed lost cities in the jungles of Central America, mapped entire Roman settlements beneath agricultural fields in Europe, and identified ancient irrigation networks in the deserts of the Middle East, all without moving a single shovel of soil. If verified, this methodology could establish a new standard for non-invasive archaeological investigation, particularly at culturally sensitive sites where excavation might be impractical or inappropriate. It represents a shift towards more sustainable archaeology, where discovery doesn't necessarily require disruption of the site itself. However, the ultimate test of any remote sensing technique is ground truthing, verifying the findings through targeted physical investigation. This verification step remains to be completed for the Giza underground city claim and represents the critical next phase in determining whether these technological methods have indeed revealed one of archaeology's most significant discoveries. The path from announcement to accepted discovery in archaeology follows a rigorous process designed to separate genuine breakthroughs from misinterpretations or wishful thinking. This process is particularly stringent for claims of this magnitude. The alleged underground city at Giza now faces a multi-stage verification journey that could take years to complete. The first crucial step is peer review of the original research. The team has submitted their methodology and findings to several prominent archaeological journals, where experts in remote sensing, Egyptology, and archaeological geophysics will scrutinize every aspect of their work. They'll examine questions like, does the technology actually work as described? Were the data processing methods valid? Are there alternative explanations for the patterns observed? Dr. Fatima Al-Badri, an independent archaeologist specializing in Egyptian subterranean structures, explained the challenge. Peer reviewers will be looking for rigorous elimination of false positives. Natural geological features can create remarkably regular patterns that mimic human construction, especially in limestone environments like the Giza Plateau. Alongside formal peer review, the discovery claim has ignited intense debate within the archaeological community. Some experts point to historical records that might support the existence of extensive underground structures. Ancient texts occasionally reference halls beneath the sacred mounds and chambers of preparation beneath the eternal houses. However, these passages have traditionally been interpreted metaphorically rather than literally. Others note that previous claims of dramatic discoveries at Giza have repeatedly failed to materialize. In the 1990s, seismic surveys suggested a chamber beneath the Sphinx, but subsequent investigation found no such feature. In 2017, a void detected within the Great Pyramid using muon radiography generated tremendous excitement, but further analysis suggested it might be a previously known stress-relieving feature rather than a secret chamber. The historical context of pyramid research also includes numerous fraudulent and misrepresented claims, from Napoleon-era treasure hunting to modern pseudoscientific theories. This legacy of speculation makes the scientific community particularly cautious when evaluating new discoveries at this iconic site. If verified, however, the implications of this discovery would be profound. Dr. James Harrington from Cambridge University's Department of Ancient History explains, "An underground complex of this scale would fundamentally change our understanding of Old Kingdom capabilities and resources. The engineering knowledge required would exceed what we've previously attributed to 4th Dynasty Egypt." The discovery might also transform our understanding of the purpose of the Giza complex. Rather than solely a necropolis and monument to deceased pharaohs, this might have functioned as an integrated ceremonial, administrative, and possibly even residential center with both above-ground and below-ground components. This would align with emerging views of ancient Egyptian sacred sites as multifunctional spaces rather than single-purpose monuments. The verification process now moves towards the critical ground-truthing phase. The Egyptian Ministry of Antiquities has outlined a potential three-phase investigation plan, pending review by their scientific committee. The first phase would involve minimally invasive techniques like targeted core sampling and microcameras inserted through small boreholes. Only if these preliminary investigations yield promising results would more intense exploration be considered. Dr. Samira Naguib, spokesperson for the ministry, emphasized the caution that would guide any physical investigation. "We must balance scientific curiosity against preservation. These monuments have stood for over 4,500 years. We won't risk damaging them in pursuit of answers, however intriguing the questions might be." Any excavation at such a significant site also involves complex political, cultural, and ethical considerations. The pyramids aren't just archaeological sites, they're powerful symbols of Egyptian heritage and identity. Decisions about investigation methods require balancing international scientific interest with national sovereignty over cultural heritage. The timeline for verification remains uncertain. The peer review process typically takes months, while planning and approval for physical investigation could extend to years. During this time, the archaeological community will continue analyzing the available data and develop hypotheses that can be tested if excavation proceeds. For the public, this situation offers a rare window into how archaeological knowledge actually develops. Not through instant discovery and immediate certainty, but rather a careful process of hypothesis, testing, verification, and interpretation. The excitement of potential discovery must be tempered with the patience required for proper scientific assessment. Whether the underground city ultimately proves to be a revolutionary discovery or a misinterpretation of complex geological features, the investigation itself will advance our methods and knowledge. The technology developed for this research will likely find applications at other archaeological sites, while the debate spurs new questions about ancient Egyptian capabilities and practices. As we await further developments in this fascinating archaeological mystery, we're reminded that our understanding of the ancient world is constantly evolving. What seems impossible today may become established fact tomorrow, or fade into the long history of Giza pyramid theories that briefly captured imagination but failed to withstand scientific scrutiny. The pyramid builders left us not just their monumental structures, but an enduring puzzle that continues to challenge our most advanced technologies and our most brilliant minds. If you've enjoyed this exploration of archaeological detective work, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more deep dives into ancient mysteries and modern discoveries. And if you have theories of your own about what might lie beneath the pyramids, share them in the comments below.